बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम स्टूडेंट हियर मी योर बायोलॉजी टीचर फ्रॉम IYS एंड फर्स्ट स्टूडेंट आई एम गिविंग यू सम इंस्ट्रक्शंस ओके लिसन माय इंस्ट्रक्शंस केयरफुली कीप योर बायोलॉजी बुक विद यू ओके एंड टेक अ स्क्रीनशॉट ऑफ एवरी स्लाइड एज वेल एज होम टास्क लाइट डन एंड द थर्ड हाइड योर वीडियो ड्यूरिंग माई लेक्चर स्टूडेंट्स टूडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग द चैप्टर नंबर 9 ओके And the chapter number 9 is transport. Transport, and first try to understand, the transport in animals we are going to learn today. You know, in my previous class, I have taught you about the transport in plants. Okay, you know, according to the living organisms, today we will learn how the transport occur into the animals and. First, what is the meaning of the transport? Transport is a process by which the things and goods or things or people are transported from one place to another place. Okay, and like plants, animals do have to transport gases, nutrients, waste, etc. From inside and outside the body, it is very much necessary to maintain the metabolism of the living body. Okay, students, so means first, this is the transport in animals. According to the types of living organisms, according to the types of animals, the transport in animals is divided into two types, okay? Because we have two types of animals, unicellular animals and multicellular animals, okay? Unicellular, uni means one cell organisms or animals, or multi means many, multicellular animals, okay? So means according to the types of animals, the transport in animals is divided into two types. We will discuss today, we will learn inshallah ta'ala today, the transport in unicellular animals like amoeba, chylamydomonas, euglena, okay? And as well as today we will learn the transport in multicellular organisms or animals like man, okay? That means first we are going to learn about the transport in unicellular animals, okay? What is in the unicellular animals? Means see on your screen, what is this organism? This is the amoeba, okay? And you can easily observe into the unicellular organisms, you know, the cell membrane. Observe, this is the cell membrane, okay? Cell membrane and the basic processes means diffusion is very much important. What am I saying to you? Again, I'm telling you, in the unicellular organism, the cell membrane and the diffusion process play an important role in transport. Why? Because you see this, because you know cell membrane is semi-permeable in nature. Okay, what is it? Is semi-permeable in nature and it only allows the active particle inside the body of the animals. Okay, and as well as you know the all materials are transported across the cell membrane by the process, either by the active transport or the passive transport. It depends upon the concentration or amount of the material outside or inside the body. Okay, beta, I mean, it is very much important in unicellular living organisms. Plasma membrane and the process of diffusion is very much important. Okay, and you know what are you observing into the amoeba? See this diagram. Observe the diagram of the amoeba. Cytoplasm is filled inside the amoeba. Okay, it is completely filled and it is very much close to the cell membrane. It is very much close to the cell membrane. Are you seeing? And it is in contact with the environment. Okay, and in these animals, what happened? The gases. What? The oxygen gas is coming inside and the carbon dioxide gas is going outside. Okay. In these animals, the gases diffuse through the diffusion process by the body surface, okay, and reach to the mitochondria. What am I saying? Means cell membrane is here. Okay, cytoplasm is filled inside the amoeba. Means the gases dissolve inside the cytoplasm and carbon dioxide gas diffuses out by the process of diffusion. Okay, and when the oxygen enters into the cytoplasm, it reaches to the mitochondria. Why? Because the mitochondria are the organelles and they are responsible to release the energy. Okay, to release the energy like that. You are seeing this is the process of gaseous exchange occur into the amoeba of transport gases. For the transport gases in and out is very much important. Like that, you know, excretion process in these animals, in unicellular living organisms, it takes place by the body surface. You are seeing this is a contractile vacuole. You are seeing, you know, better what happens, this contractile vacuole, when it is filled with the waste material, it comes very close to the cell membrane and it bursts. It bursts and all the excretory material go out in the outside the body. Goes out outside the body and this vacuole membrane again become a vacuole like structure and it goes back inside the body and the cell membrane again becomes repair. Okay, first is rupture and the material goes out from the body and again it repairs. Okay, so means the excretion process and the transport of gases, transport of excreted material outside the body. And also you remember in chapter 7, I have explained you nutrition in amoeba as well. Okay, and in nutrition in amoeba as well, what we have learned? So means what we have learned, the amoeba identify the food and the food is in goes inside the body by the pseudopodia projections. Those are made by the cell membrane as well. Okay, so means diffuse by the diffusion process. Food nutrients, gases, excretory material, all these materials are transported inside and outside the body of the amoeba by the process of diffusion. Okay, but the cell membrane is play the very much important role, all these processes to maintain the metabolism, and as well as cytoplasm plays a very much important role in the transport of these material. Okay students, now we are moving towards the transport, how the transport occurs into the multicellular organisms or animals. The examples of the multicellular animals are the man. Okay, and we have the many advanced animals, all vertebrates are involved in are the multicellular organisms. Okay, and you know, but into the multicellular living organisms, you know, multicellular living organisms, this one, these is to these animals having very complex body. These animals having complex body, complex body systems, and they have distance between different body parts. You know, we are the human beings and we have very complex body. We have body systems, but we have distance between our body organs, liver and pancreas and excretory system and heart, these and lungs, these organs having distance, and brain as well. Okay, so means because of these system between these parts, the multicellular organisms need a system for transportation. They need very advanced system, complex system, and this system in the multicellular organisms, the transport system is also called circulatory system. What is called, beta? This is called the circulatory system. First, try to understand the meaning of this word circulate. Circulate means when the circulate means the complete a one cycle from, because the function or process from where it is starting again complete and take a complete circle inside the body, it again come back on its original place like a circle. Okay, that's why the circulatory system, the in multicellular organisms, to transport the nutrients and gases and all these processes are done by the system, and this system is called circulatory system. Okay, Okay, again, according to the type of animals, okay, we have two types of circulatory system, open circulatory system and closed circulatory system. Okay, but you know, first you remember in physics or in science in beginning classes, you have learned about the circulatory system means open circuits and closed circuits to for the electricity we have in our houses. Okay, that means recall your memory. What is your open circuit mean and what is the closed circuit? Like that in the animal's body, according to the animals, according again I'm telling you, according to the types of animals, we have two types of circulatory system: open type circulatory system and closed type circulatory system. Okay. Now, what is the open type? Again, already I have told you, we have two types of living organisms: unicellular living organisms, we have multicellular living organisms. According to the living organisms, we have two types of transport system. Transport system are two, okay? But according to the types of multicellular living organisms, they have the circulatory system. This circulatory system is again divided into further two types because multicellular animals are of two types. Okay, means open type circulatory system and closed type circulatory system. Okay, first I am sharing with you about what is the open type circulatory system. Okay, so means what is the open type circulatory system? Observe the diagram carefully. You know, this is you observe the diagram. What the organism is present? Yes, grasshopper is here. Okay, so means this open type circulatory system mostly present into the molluscus and arthropod. What the grasshopper is? Grasshopper is arthropod. Okay, it is the terrestrial arthropod. Okay, done. And also molluscus. Okay, it is present into the organism. Those are found into the phylum mollusca. Okay, done. And what are you observing? These are the blood vessels. This is the artery, very clear picture, and this is the ostia and valves. What are valves? What is the function of the valves? Valves are also present in this system. But what is this system and why this system is called open type circulatory system, students? Why beta? Because in this system, blood does not flow inside the vessels. What mean by vessels? These are the vessels I'm telling you. But what mean by this? You know, here the blood capillaries are not for the exchange of material. They are not exchange the material. They are open. Okay, means capillaries are not joining together. Means direct these capillaries or vessels are open into the open tissue spaces. These are the blood body cells, the tissue. Means these blood vessels are directly exchange the material inside the tissues by opening into the tissue spaces called sinuses or hemocoel. Sinuses or hemocoel. Okay, I'm telling you. So means because of this means the material and all materials are not directly come in the contact with the means these all materials and substances and nutrients are directly come in the contact with the tissues. Have you got it, my point? What am I saying? The food materials and all hormones and vitamins and nutrients are directly come in the contact with the tissues. Okay. To transport means that's why this system is called open type circulatory system. Have you got it, my point? Okay, and after exchange the material, blood enters into the heart. You are seeing the blood enters again. You observe my cursor. Blood is again going back towards the heart. This is the heart structure. Okay, and from where the blood is pumped again, you are seeing this is the artery, and through this artery is coming. New artery is a vessel. These are the vessels, but the blood and the materials are directly come in the contact with the tissues. That's why these are called the open type circulatory system. Okay, beta, to mean this is the open type circulatory system. And what is the function of valves? You know, valves always prevent the backflow. You know, blood is going towards the heart. You know, again, arrows are not coming back towards the body cells. Why? Because the valves are present. Because of these valves and ostia are the places like they work like a chamber. Okay, so means the blood does not backflow. Okay, so means valves perform this function and they stop the backflow of the blood. Done. Okay, Janam. After that, what happened? means we are going to move the closed type circulatory system. Where we are going to move? We are moved towards the closed type circulatory system. Closed means, and what happened in this system? This system, actually closed type circulatory system, blood flows in vessels, okay, but it does not direct contact with the tissues. It never comes out in direct contact with the tissues. What mean by this? First I'm telling you that I'm showing you diagram. This is the closed type. You know, you are seeing, observe my cursor, the vessels are interconnected with each other. There is no space, means they are not direct contact with the, these are the tissues, okay beta, the body cells. That means these vessels are not directly contact with the tissues, okay, means that's why this is called the closed type circulatory system. Okay, done. To me, this is a circulatory system, and this system is present in man, invertebrates, okay, and few invertebrates also. Only few invertebrates having, like earthworm. You are seeing this picture. What is this organism? This is the arthropod. What is this? This is the arthropod, and it belongs to the phylum Annelida. Remember, okay. And as well as the closed type circulatory system is found in man body. Okay. So means closed type circulatory system, a system in which the blood flows into the closed blood tubular blood vessels and never comes out in direct contact with the tissues. Okay, and but you know, because we are the human beings, or in man, the closed type circulatory system is found, and you know, it is composed of the many components. What are these components, beta? These components are heart, blood, and blood vessels. I know you have a little bit knowledge about all these components, but I'm telling you, these are the main components of the closed type circulatory system. Okay, the diagram, I hope you all of them have understood. Okay, now this is the heart. Human heart, as an organ of closed type circulatory system, is the main organ, okay, of the closed type circulatory system. Okay, what happened? What is the heart? Heart, what is heart? Heart is a muscular, strong muscular pumping organ. Okay, and it is enclosed in a membrane, and this membrane is the pericardium membrane. Okay, and it is composed of the atria. This is aorta. Okay, and this is the large blood vessel. This is the aorta. Okay, and these are the vessels. These are the vena cavas, or you can observe these are atrium. These are ventricles. Okay, these are the four chambers are present. Left auricle, right auricle, and combinedly they are called atrium. These are the left ventricle and right ventricle combinedly. Okay, they are the two ventricles are here. You can easily observe in this picture, these are the valves. Okay, valves are present here, and the valves prevent the back flow of the blood. Okay, done. So means this is the structure of the heart, and heart is the main organ of the circulatory system of man. Okay, closed type circulatory system. Now I'm moving towards the what are the blood vessels. Okay, but first, before telling you about the blood vessels, I am telling you about the blood. What am I telling you about the blood? What is blood? You know, there are three main components. Heart, I have discussed with you. Now the blood, what is blood? Blood is a special kind of connective tissue. Blood is a special kind of connective tissue which circulates in the fluid form in the man body. Okay, and it transports substances in, and it is composed of the plasma. Okay, and as well as it is composed of the cellular part, means it also contains the corpuscles. Corpuscles means red blood cells, white blood cells. Okay, it all, and platelets. These are the corpuscles which are present in the blood. Okay, and heart is the most important organ. After that, the blood, it is helped to transport blood. Okay, and transport the food nutrients and inside the man body, and in the closed type circulatory system. The third component of this closed type circulatory system is the blood vessels. What they are? They are blood vessels, and enclosed type circulatory system, three types of blood vessels are working. Okay, what are these blood vessels? These blood vessels are arteries, veins, and capillaries. What they are, students? They are arteries, veins, and capillaries. Okay, so now what are these blood vessels? First artery, what are arteries? Arteries are the blood vessels that carry blood away from the heart. Okay, means they carry the oxygenated blood. Veins, veins are the blood vessels, those that carry blood from body towards the heart. Mean why? Because this blood is without oxygen. This is the deoxygenated blood. And the second vessels are the capillaries. Capillaries are very much fine, microscopic, okay. And these microscopic blood vessels are found into the cell of the tissues. Okay, students. Now, I'm going to explain the comparison between all of them. Okay, I am going to explain the comparison between both of them. This is the arteries, veins, and capillaries. Okay, arteries carry blood from heart to various organs of the body. Okay, and veins bring blood towards the heart from various organs of the body because the blood is deoxygenated, and the through arteries the blood carry towards the organ. It is the oxygenated blood. Third are the capillaries. Capillaries are very fine, microscopic blood vessels, and they are responsible to exchange of substances between the blood and tissues is taking place by the capillaries. Okay, then this is the main function. This is the first point, is the function of all these blood vessels. Now I'm moving towards what the arteries have, the having the narrow lumen. What mean by narrow lumen? See here, arteries having the what are they saying? Arteries having the narrow lumen. Lumen means, you are seeing that this is the circular portion, this is the diameter, means the entering from where the blood flows. This entering of the vessel is called the lumen. What is called lumen? So means arteries having the narrow lumen. Why? Why they have the narrow lumen, beta? Because the arteries walls are thick. The arteries walls are thick, and why they have the thick walls? See here, why they have the thick walls? Because you know, arteries the walls of the arteries consist of the three layers. Consist of the three layers. The innermost layer, okay, which is made up of the epithelial. Epithelial tissues, are you seeing? This is the innermost layer. It is made up of epithelial tissues. Okay, this is the middle layer. Okay, you are seeing, and the middle layer, it is very much mostly smooth, and muscles and elastic fibers are present. Okay, this is the second layer, and the third layer of the arteries walls is made up of flexible connective tissues. They are called collagen fibers. Okay, means the this is the innermost layer made by the epithelial tissues, second layer made by the layer of muscles, and this is very much elastic fibers. Okay, and the third layer is made by the collagen fibers. Those are also the part of the connective tissues. Because of these three layers, the walls are very much thick. That's why the lumen of the arteries are very much the lumen of the arteries is narrow. Okay, have you understood this? Now I'm telling you about the veins. We have discussed about the function of the veins. Veins having the wider lumen and their walls are thin. Okay, so means what happened? Now see the diagram of the veins. These are the veins that you can easily observe. This is the lumen of the veins, and the lumen is broad than arteries. Okay, why? Because you can easily observe, because the veins are also composed of the three layers. Okay, like arteries, they are also the composed of the three layers, but the layers of the arteries are very thin. That's why, okay, the walls of the arteries, the walls of the veins are thin, okay, than arteries. That's why the lumen is broader. Again, I'm repeating, the lumen of the arteries is narrow, but the lumen of the veins is broad. Why? Because again, see the picture. This is the picture of the arteries. The arteries having composed of three layers, but these layers are thick walls. Okay, the layers of the cell are thick walls. That's why the lumen is narrow. But in veins, veins are also composed of three layers. Okay, but these three layers of the cells are thin than arteries. That's why the veins, veins having the wide central lumen. Okay, so means I hope you all of them have got it understanding. And what are the capillaries? Capillaries have the lumen slightly larger than RBCs. Why? Means they have the very, very fine and very smallest lumen. Means how much it is smallest? Means only they are slightly larger than RBCs. Why? Because means RBCs can flow very easily and they can exchange the material between tissues and blood. That's why these capillaries are very fine and microscopic, and the walls are very thin walled. Okay, so means I'm showing you the picture. See here, these are the capillaries, student. These are arterioles, these are the venules. Okay, these are the veins and capillaries, but they divided into very fine capillaries network. You can easily observe when they can easily exchange the material. These are the tissue cells, and you can easily observe how the material is exchanged through these capillaries, because the capillaries walls are very fine and microscopic for exchange the material. Okay, beta, now after this discussion, what have you observed? Means after differentiation of all these points, we got that and we learned that because of the wider lumen, because the lumen is the wider and the walls are thicker, means arteries have which type of blood pressure? Yeah, they have the high blood pressure, you know, sometime in case of any injuries and cut on our finger, the blood oozes out from our fingers in very high pressure because the arteries having the high blood pressure. Okay, and veins are thin walls, and that's why the pressure of the veins having the very low blood pressure, and the capillaries also having the low blood pressure. Okay, because of that, this is the differentiation of we have discussed about the blood capillaries. Okay, but now what are I'm telling you about the blood vessels first again. Means the blood vessels, the vessels those run inside the man bodies and through all the tissues of the body, while some blood vessels, you know, I'm going to tell about the amazing thing about the blood vessels. You know, some blood vessels are wide, means they are wide and broad. How much they are broad? They are broad. They are means according to our thumb. Thumb, you know, we have finger and thumb in our hand. They are broad like our thumb. Okay, and some are very much fine like hairs as well. Okay, students, so means these are the differentiation of the blood vessels. I have told you in detail. I hope you all of them have understood them. Okay, so means after that, you know, beta, the man having the closed type circulatory system. Okay, as well as so means the main arteries. You know, I'm telling you about the most. I'm telling you about the something about the arteries, veins, and capillaries. Means the which one? You know, the pulmonary arteries. You know, we have discussed about the function of the arteries. Means arteries carry the oxygenated blood from heart to all organs of the body. And they have having the oxygenated blood, except only the one. Only the one artery. Which artery having the deoxygenated blood? Yes, only the pulmonary artery. It is the single one artery. Okay, it is a single one artery which having the deoxygenated blood. Okay, and this artery is arise and originate from the right ventricle of the heart. It arises from the right ventricle of the heart, and it pumps blood and carry the oxygenated blood where it carries blood towards the lungs for oxygenation. Okay, so means arteries are very much important, and the left ventricle of the heart pump blood through the aorta. So means pulmonary artery and aorta, you know, in the diagram we have discussed, you know, you see this diagram again of the heart. This is the diagram of the heart, you know, from the right ventricle. Okay, the pulmonary artery arises, you are seeing blue in color, and it take the deoxygen blood towards the heart for oxygenation, as well as aorta. Aorta is the broad vessels of the arteries, okay, and it carry blood towards the all parts of the body, but it contains the oxygenated blood, and this aorta is descends down and divided into many fine branches and transport the blood to all parts of the body with brain. Okay, done. Like that means I am telling you about the amazing fact, an amazing thing or information about the veins. You know, veins, the function of the veins, carry blood from the body parts, from the body towards the heart, means this blood is deoxygenated blood. Means which one? Only the single vein. Which vein? Only the pulmonary vein. Pulmonary vein contains the oxygenated blood. Which blood? Yeah, the pulmonary vein is the single one vein which contains the oxygenated blood, and it carry blood again. It carry blood from lungs towards the heart into the left auricle or left atrium. Why? Because the blood is coming from the lungs. Okay, and this lungs is with oxygen, that's why it enters into the left atrium. Okay, and a student, as well as you know, the valves are also present inside the heart. Okay, to again see the diagram, valves are also present to prevent the backflow as well. Okay, so means now after that I'm telling you about the amazing thing about the capillaries. Capillaries are left. Okay, capillaries are the microscopic blood vessels we have discussed. Okay, they are found in the cell of the tissues. Okay, and the walls of the capillaries are made up of single layer of flattened cell called endothelium. What are these? The cell names is endothelium. Okay, and capillaries walls are partially permeable, means semi-permeable. Why? Because they you know about the semi-permeable membrane is able to absorb the and transport the nutrient by the process of diffusion. Okay, and these capillaries are originated from the arterioles. Okay, and from the venules, and also you know capillaries increase the surface area. Capillaries also increase the surface area for exchange the substances between blood and the tissues. Okay, again observe the diagram of the capillaries. You can observe here, these are the capillaries here. Okay, these are the arteries and these are the venules, students. Okay, now again I'm telling you about the main veins of the body. You know, many scientists also work about the different, and if sometimes we can face the disorders. These disorders are called the cardiovascular disorders because of the blood vessels. Okay, but now I'm not discussing about these facts. Okay, but I'm just telling you about the arteries, amazing arteries. I have discussed about the pulmonary arteries. I have told you about the aorta. You know what are the arteries? Those arise directly from the heart and they again transport blood towards the heart. What are these arteries? The name of these arteries, it is the coronary arteries. Okay, coronary arteries. I have told you about the pulmonary artery contains the deoxygenated blood. It's a single one artery. Okay, I have told you about the aorta, and I have shown you the diagram, aorta having the oxygenated blood. Okay, and it supply blood to all parts of the body. But the one more thing, coronary arteries, okay, these arteries arise from the heart. Okay, and they supply the blood to the walls of the heart itself. Okay, like the other branches, but the other branches carry blood to the brain and the other parts of the human body. Okay, like that, human students, we have discussed about the two types of system, open type, but it was the detail of the transport system in animals, but according to the closed type circulatory system. Okay, so now again I'm giving you review of my topic today. Today's my topic was transport in animals. Okay, and again I'm telling you the review, and you can take a screenshot very easily. Okay, I'm starting from beginning, beta. Today my chapter was chapter 9, transport, and today I discussed and we learned about the transport system in animals. Because of the types of animals, we have transport system in animals, two types of transport system, means transport system in unicellular animals and transport system in multicellular or animals, because we have two types of animals, okay? But you know, in unicellular animals, the main important role is played by the cell membrane, which is semi-permeable in nature, okay? And as well as the diffusion process is very much important. You can easily observe the diagram of the amoeba here, means for transport of gases, means of transport of nutrients, transport of waste material. These living organisms use the diffusion process, and this process is occurs by the cell membrane, and cytoplasm plays in very important role. Okay, and today we discussed about the transport system into the multicellular organisms. But you know, multicellular animals are of two types, okay? Because of the types of animals, we have two types of, you know, in animals, the transport system is also called the circulatory system. Because of animals, we have two types of circulatory system: open type circulatory system and closed type circulatory system. In open type circulatory system, we have discussed, this is a diagram, the blood is does not, you know, in open type circulatory system means the material or blood is not directly contact with the tissues, okay? It does not flow, and it does not contact with the direct tissues. It direct contact with the tissues, okay, and exchange the material. That's why it is called the open type circulatory system, okay? And the good examples are the grasshopper, okay? And in this system, the blood is direct contact with the tissues and transport material into the spaces, and these spaces are called the hemocoel or sinuses, okay? Today we discuss about the closed type circulatory system, and the closed type in the closed type circulatory system, the blood travels or transport material by the closed type blood vessels, okay? And it is never come in direct contact with the tissues, okay? These material are exchanged by the capillaries, and this system composed of three components: heart, blood, and blood vessels. Heart is the strong pumping organ, okay beta, and the blood is a special type of connective tissue, okay, and which circulate in the fluid form, okay, and it transport the substances, and it is composed of the plasma and the cellular portion, okay. And this is a closed type, this is the hard structure, and today I have discussed with you the blood. You can blood vessels, take a screenshot as well, okay beta. This is the differentiation of the capillaries, take a screenshot, hurry up. And these are the arteries, structures, capillaries, and veins. And many knowledge is also present in your book. You can see your book as well in detail. You have to study. And now I'm sharing with you the home task. Okay. The question number one is explain way of transporting unicellular organisms like amoeba with diagram. You will write the answer from slide number 4 and 5. And how does the process of transport occurs in multicellular animals? Also give the name of type of circulatory system, slide number 6, okay? Write three differences between the following: open type and closed type. We will write the answer by making columns, okay? From slide number 7 to 10, and arteries and veins from slide number 13, okay beta? Draw a neat and label diagram of the open type and closed type circulatory system from the slide number 8 and 10. Okay, Allah Hafiz, and inshallah we will meet together in the next class, okay? Allah Hafiz.